Hi makeup lovers, this is Shaila today with this very nudish and bronzy kind of look. This is the eyes I did today. They are very glamorized. It can be done, it can be worn during the spring season with any kind of outfit. It is a very neutral makeup and it can be worn with any color of makeup. So this is like a very basic color technique for you to learn, and it will help you to achieve this look very easily. The first step, I have primed my eyes using the P. Louis base, the best out there, and it's Remore 0.05, excellent base. I will be going in the crease. First of all, I'll bring on all of lid with this color, like a basic light peachish brown shade, which is the same color as my skin, but a tone darker, like this. Then I will take this shade, which is like a darker brown, medium dark brown kind of shade, and create the crease. As I have hooded eyes, this is my very important step in the creation of any eye look I do. This eye look is going to be extremely simple, no complications involved. So I am just darkening up the crease. To create a nice demarcation, I'm going down like this. Take this cream shadow, which is by Charlotte Tilbury, Star Gold. Beautiful. Take on a fluffy brush like this and then start applying. I hope you can appreciate the beauty of this color. How amazing! It's a very nice copper gold. And I will give it some time to set. Inglot shadow in brown, Mantra, I think so. And then a brush, which is like an angle brush. I will go in the eye, outer corner of the eye, inner corner of the eye, dispersing it along the eye, pulling the eye up, and applying here. I will go in again. And then along the lower lash line. That's a lot of brown. I get my eyes watered, so I will just wait for a minute for the eyes to settle down like this. I'm not doing anything, just leaving it here so the water can seep into the tissue another time. And now I will clean the brush and I will go in on top of everything that we have already done. I will go in with this blending brush and I will blend out the edges. I will take a Q-tip. I will clean the outer edge. A very important step, cleaning the outer edge, because my eyes will keep on watering if I don't clean it. I will go in again in the brown and then I will line the lower waterline on both sides and I will leave it like this. So the next step, I will be taking a golden shade, which is MAC Dazzle Shadow Liquid. This is here. Looks like it, and it goes on top of my already applied gold shade. So this has a bit of the shimmer, a glitter, a beauty to it, and it goes down. It is pretty liquidy. We will give it some time to set before we move it around. So I will just keep my eyes closed for a second or so. I will take the same brush we used for the very first base. And then I will start blending around the edges. nicely done. So in my opinion, I should stop here. Just a few bits and pieces. Any flat brush, take this light golden shade here, tap off the excess and go under the brow bone. It will enhance the brow bone. Then I will go in with this brown. No more brown in it, just the previous brown, and I will just blend out around the edges. Some of this brown here, which is like a really beautiful dark burgundish brown kind of shade, and I will just darken the edges here a little bit. And this should be it. I'll be applying the Sephora size of mascara, and I will be applying the lashes in by Charlotte Tilbury in Glamour. Beautiful lashes, very lightweight, and they last pretty long. I have been using them for quite a while now. Lashes have been applied, and now the very last step will be the Charlotte Tilbury Champagne Diamonds in the inner corner. I always apply it. So girls, this is the finished look of today's makeup. I will be pairing with two outfits, and I will be sharing it with you. I hope you like this tutorial. Please follow me on my Instagram. Please follow me on my YouTube, and keep sharing your love.